Hello guys, today we are playing a 1v1 matchup on a beautiful map West Mnet in Battle for Middle Earth 1 on the patch 2.22 with the Mordor faction against Isengard. Sauron versus Saruman. Evil versus evil. Unlike in the films, they actually used to be allies in the films, but yet they never supported each other directly, unlike Rohan, which was the main carry of the film, hands down.
We should be the master.
Gollum and build an orc pit. Let's build an army worthy of Mordor, guys, shall we? I mean, this map is a bit tricky because we have not many trees around the settlements, as you can see and tell. That's why building slaughterhouses might actually be a better call here. Because lumber mills, they can only give you money if you have a bunch of trees around them. And we need to still build like 2 lumber mills just to get the wood bonus. Wood bonus is essential for Mordor early game to build everything a bit cheaper. But I like this front slaughterhouse because slaughterhouse got buffed in the version 2.22. Now it's cheaper. Oh! Uruks. Oh man. Every time I see Urukai, guys, I always keep remembering what Gimli is saying. You know, this is no rubble of mine. This orcs. These are Urukai. But the mindless orcs, they can also be very strong. They will be outnumbering you every single time. Okay, we're in a good spot. I don't mind about losing the slaughterhouse in front. As long as we can deal some economical damage, we can also use Eye of Sauron in the last possible second to get a bit more experience from destroying this lumber mill. So basically, in the version 2.22, orcs, when they get level 2, they get a huge power spike. They will be unlocking the new Bloodthirsty ability, which is reworked for the patch. So earlier, in previous versions, it used to give you the chance to eat your allied orcs to actually gain some experience, which was kind of useless in many situations. But now, it's a passive ability, which will increase the damage of orcs by 25%. So trying to get them to level 2 is actually very, very strong. And you guys know me, I like challenges a lot, and for that reason we will be trying our best to win this matchup without any catapult. We will not even build the siege forks in this game. Normally Mordor's strength against Isengard are the siege weapons, because the second he is using the freezing rain, all our leadership bonuses are getting completely negated. But no challenge, no fun. For that reason we will be trying our best. Look, our golem though, our golem is crazy. We will be trying our best to win this without catapults. I mean, Mordor's late game is still unmatched. The chance for you to recruit 3 flying heroes is extremely powerful and super underrated. Maybe you guys don't understand how impactful this can actually be. Like, 3 flying heroes, which can only be shot by the crossbowmen. That's the only thing that can damage them, you know? And if you can do nothing with them, you can still make sure to keep your map control protected and keep killing enemy Lumbermills. It's the least you can do with those Nazguls. Oh, let's kill him. You see how impactful Gollum is actually, guys, at the beginning of the game? Don't underestimate him. Size doesn't matter everything. That's what she said. Hey, I didn't say that. Okay, don't flame me in the comment section down below. Size, okay? Don't do that. Okay, I mean, we are doing good. We actually almost destroyed all his eco. It's very good for us. Look at this orcs, boys. Level 2, and we have almost attained land 2. That's good. And now we need to spam orcs. From 2 orc fists, that's gonna be enough. And we also need to build the troll cage later on, just in case he might go for a blade rush. I mean, we need to make sure that we survive the early game, and that's definitely possible with the orc spam. So we can spam orcs every single time. Yes, orcs are weaker than uruks, but uruks, they cost 200 each, and orcs are for free. So when you can kill 1 uruk with 3 orcs, it's okay. You know, it's very good.
We've run into some laborers. Get to work. All right.
Oh, look at this cutie Gollum. You know, Gollum is looking so cute. And Gollum can be so annoying, you know what I'm saying? Especially early game against Lumbermill workers, and also against good factions like Gondor and Rohan. You can chase down those peasants and soldiers all the time. You will be faster than them. They can never disengage from you. And later on, you can also use them like a scout. So basically, you can put them next on you know, anywhere on the map. And then you have like permanent vision control, which is very good. Oh, look, the Lumbermill workers. They are going crazy on me.
Stay alert.
sneaky little Lumbermy workers. Okay. We need to try to get to the power, you know, to the point in which we can unlock the industry. That's the goal, and we can do that by creeping now at the bottom right side with the tainted land. We can creep this a bit faster. We can also use the Eye of Sauron later on. Oh, hey, Lumber Mill workers. Hey, why, you know, don't do that to my golem. Don't, okay, here's a tower there. We need to be careful. Let's go to his mill. Okay, so we should be deep, able to defend this. And the second our troll is on the field, we should be in a very good spot. I'm gonna use both of them actually, just to make sure that we have additional damage and armor, which is pretty good. And creeping, creeping, creeping. And then we can also capture those outposts to make even more orc pits to constantly pressure the Isengard player. That's the goal. Keep pressuring him. Oh, what a timing, dude. Unlucky timing for you. Unlucky timing because my troll is all about to enter the battlefield. So your 3 Uruk-hash is not going to achieve you too much. Trust me on that one. Nice, two boys. Nice. So we crept the work layer. We might lose one of the slaughterhouses, which is not a big deal. I mean, we can replace it. And now we can also capture this outpost. But first of all, let's defend ourselves with the mountain troll. I mean, keep pressuring him all the time, you know? The orcs, you need to... You know, micro is very important in Battle for Middle-earth 1, but when you play Mordor, macro is even more important. So don't underestimate your orcs. You know, quantity has a quality at its own. So basically, you can outspam any faction you want. Look at this. We are creeping with the orcs. We are pressuring with the orcs. We are defending with the orcs. You know, orcs, orcs, orcs. The age of man is over, ladies and gentlemen. The age of the orc has come. A new horde of orcs. Hike down, you maggots. And the second you don't pay attention, you are actually growing rich. That's good. So we can now capture this one more time. Slaughterhouse, because there are no trees nearby. Very important. And we can now creep. So basically what you can do, when you try to creep the troll layer solo with your mountain troll, it can be quite risky. Because there is a chance, and a high chance actually, that the troll is knocking down your troll on the ground. But if you have like orcs... Oh, look at this guy. He was capturing the outpost. I see you, bro. I see you. Look, there are no trees nearby. You see that? Look how many workers we have around this side. So you see, with the, you know, orcs nearby, we can actually make sure to creep this easier. And now creep this troll layer. Work layer, I mean, with the second troll. Oh, he's building a tower too. So it's going to be hard for me now to take down his outpost anytime soon. But it's okay. Because if you don't know, as you are losing orcs, you are also generating power points. So spamming orcs is super important in any matchup. But especially against Isengard. Okay, nice too, nice too, nice too. Orc pit and 2 furnaces. Our next goal is going to be to recruit a Nazgul ASAP. So here's a Lord on the field. I mean, not a Lord, it's the Lord. I also see some Berserkers on the field. But first of all, let's ignore that all and go for a creeping action. And we want to get also Darkness unlocked later on to make our units very, very strong. Nice, so we need one more troll to get the troll cage to level 2. Before we will be recruiting some Drummer Trolls. Nice, ooh, Mountain Trolls, dude, I'm telling you. Who needs upgrades? You know, who needs heavy armor and forge blades if you have the monsters on your side? Look them, they are punching each other. I love that. Take this. Dude, I like the trolls so much. They are so unique, by the way, and they are so strong when you have enough leadership with them. Drummer Troll, Witch King, Darkness, holy guacamole. Like, come on now. Any hero will get one-shotted. Even Aragorn will get like 2-hitted. Okay, more orcs, dude. Orcs everywhere, you know? We have in total now 4 orc pits, guys. 1 on each side, on each outpost, and then 2 in the main base. So we are able to pressure the middle from the middle, from the main base. And from the outpost, we can pressure the side lanes. Like, you know, right and left. Nice-oo, nice-oo, nice-oo. The enemy! And even more creeping action. Look at this. Look at this. I'm telling you, boys. The orc spam is real. He can't do anything about the situation. He's scared to even go for the Warg Riders. Because Warg Riders are actually quite expensive. Especially when you have not much, you know, not much map control. And the thing about the Warg Riders is, you don't know as Isengard player how far away the Mordor is from a Nazgul. Because the second a Nazgul is on the field, your Warg Riders are going to be absolutely useless. Please, I'm gonna use Tainted Land to... Oh, but my troll is actually getting chunked. Lords, die, please. Please, at least can I take you down, please? Please, 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 please. Move the Eye of Sauron. This guy is microing with the Lords. Troll, please, hit him. Hit him. Hit him already. One more hit. 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 One more...
Those hordes coming out. Get ready for fighting. Another orc.
I don't want to talk about that.
Let's move.
I don't want to talk about it.
Get those hordes coming
out. Don't tell me anything. Yes. Oh, but maybe I can. When I can steal the money, I'm happy. I'm not happy though because we just lost two trolls for no reason. Dude, sometimes you are greedy. You know what I'm saying? Can I steal the money, please? I'm not gonna look. Actually, I'm not gonna look. I hope that I'm gonna be able to steal it. Yes, I stole it. I saw the jump in my money. I stole it, guys. I stole it. But it's not worth it. We lost two trolls. It's more than 1,500 we lost. And we just get like 200. Why am I happy, actually? Why am I happy? I don't understand. Look at the Nazgul. And now I'm going to find the redemption, guys. We're going to try to kill the lords. He was actually annoying. And now I will be trying my best to kill him. Let's use Preach and Lords. You will pay for it. You will pay for it.
Hack it down.
You will pay for it, what you did to our two mountain trolls. Oh, yes, 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 yes. Now it's worth it. Now I'm happy, boys. Now I'm happy. Okay, we have 5 power points collected. We need only one more for the darkness. It's going to be a huge power spike for us. And, you know, even on orcs, it's very efficient because we will get additional armor and damage, but for the entire map, for every single unit. And darkness is very good because unlike the hero leadership, like, for example, from Theorin, it also applies on monsters, also on Mumakils. And guess what? We will also build a Mumakil man, you know? We will, you know me, boys. Mumakil Pan, Haradrim, Palestine it is. You know, we are not here to joke around, you know what I'm saying? Again, we are trying to win without catapults, and for that reason, we need the Mumakil action. So Mumakil with the darkness and also Witch King. We also need Witch King. So we need to recruit with Mumakils, but I'm assuming we should be waiting until Witch King is on the field. We shouldn't really take a step forward without the Witch King leadership. And also Witch King leadership is very unique. So now you might say, yeah, but Witch King has only the same leadership like Theoden almost. No, it's not the truth. Witch King leadership is very unique because it gives you also leadership to Mumakils. So Drama Troll doesn't. So keep that in mind. But you can still, with Darkness and Witch King, you can make your Drama Trolls extremely tanky. And what we also will do in the next patch, in the next version of the patch 2.22, is the death animation. So basically, just like in the film, if the Mumakil is burning, he will be enraging. And he will be running wild. I'm very excited about this one, guys. Please let me know in the comment section down below, what do you think about the Mumakil death animation? That when you burn him, he will get out of control, you cannot control him anymore, and he will be just running wild and trampling everything on his path. Oh my goodness. It looks dope. I hope that you will like it, guys. Look how many orcs we have. By the time he deals with the orcs, we have even more orcs. And that's the power of the orc spam, boys. That's the power of the orc spam, you know? And look how much map control we are able to get only with the orc spam, because he's pressured. So he has 100% constant pressure on himself. All he can do is defend himself. He can never push us back yet until he gets like a huge army. And because we have map control, he has no money. And because he has no money, he can... I mean, you see this loop situation? Like, it's like a paradox situation, you know what I'm saying? In order to get money, he needs map control, but he can't because of our orcs. Okay? Dude. Ooh. Okay, I think we need to bail because the archers inside the tower are also hitting like a truck. So we gotta bail with the Nazgul. Not looking to lose him.
They're attacking over here.
Okay, boys, it's time. Now we can recruit the leader of the Nine, the Witch King of Angmar. Oh, what is happening with my with my Haradrims? You see this? Are they actually inside? No, they are not inside. I don't know what's happening with them. They cannot enter. If we got, I mean, again, that's a beta testing, boys. Everything that you see, and that's why we are playing a lot of games on the beta version, just to make sure everything is working perfectly fine before we release it. And the good thing about the launcher is, which you, by the way, also can download from the link in the description, the second we have an update, all you gotta do is click on update button, and that's it. So you need never again manual downloads and putting files in the... Oh, no man can kill me. Yes, sir. Here comes the Witch King, ladies and gentlemen. And now we are talking. Now we are talking.
Stay
I mean, I would like to make like a bigger army first before we're gonna move, actually, but let's go, you know. Let's go! Trolls, charge! Mordor, assemble! And now I know, but Shanks, why don't you use trees? Because I don't need to. Imagine if they had a real weapon. I'm going ham, boys. You know me, I'm going ham. You know what I'm saying? I'm going ham. Darkness Witch King, let's go. Hopefully he has no freezing rain. Now we can actually deal so much damage. Moomba Kill Pan will be creating pressure on him. Drama Troll, please. Please, please stay nearby. Sport the Haradrims on top of the Moomba Kill with additional leadership. Take down everything. Leave nothing alive. Send forth the legions, as Witch King would like to say. We gotta be careful with the Witch King, though. Looking for a charge. But Moomba Kill is not the fastest unit in the game. And, dude, it's okay, though. He has to kite our Moomba Kill. And during all this time, our trolls can deal devastating amount of damage. Look at this. Orfang is Norfang. Get it? Get it? Okay, that was not a very nice joke, but... Oh, Lourdes is no more. Dude, Lourdes, what are you doing? You are overestimating yourself, but also underestimating our trolls. This is no troll of BFME 2 or Rise of the Witch King. These are BFME 1 trolls. They are hitting like a truck. Look at the orc army in the meantime. You know me. You know what? I'm gonna also go... I told you guys. I'm not going for the Balrog in this game, okay? You know what we're gonna do? We will be picking up later on... see it. We will be picking up later on the Cold Heart. I wanna lose stuff now. And then, with the Cold Heart, we're gonna make a full population of orcs. That's the plan. And then with the full leadership, Drummer Troll, Witch King, and Darkness, with the orcs, we will prove Isengard that Uruks are not better than orc warriors.
Orcs! We're under attack! More heroes! Look at those orcs! Keep squeezing out of that pit!
Okay, so more Moomba Kills are required for this one. We can also go for the third Nazgul, but who needs a Nazgul if you have Moomba Kill army? You know, this with the Haradrim, something is not working properly, but we gotta fix it, obviously. Don't worry about it. Everything what you see can always be fixed. I mean, unfortunately, you have a couple of limitations in Battle for Middle-earth 1. The engine is very old, so half of the stuff you want to implement is literally not possible. But, you know... One thing you need to understand, we are working on it frequently, you know what I'm saying? And that's the first time ever that BFME1 is like an official launcher, basically, which gives you the chance to update and download and everything with one single button. It's a huge achievement, even though it's 2022, you know, it's not 2004 anymore, but what can I do, boys? BFME is still my childhood game, and I cannot let it go. I cannot let it go. Let's destroy this, please. Aesu, Aesu. Okay, then we will be building up this orc, you know, the orc pits there at the outpost we will be just capturing. And then it's time, boys. It's a hella... Oh, he's using War Chant. I know, I see you. But my Witch King is coming. And your Titter is gonna fall. In the meantime, dude, we are command point supply capped. We are always supply capped. We cannot recruit more units. Because orcs, they cost no money, but they cost command points. A lot of command points. They cost actually 30 command points each. So you cannot spam them unlimited. It would be kind of busted if you could. Imagine Oryx would literally cost 0 command points too, you know what I'm saying? Imagine you could feel like the entire map with Oryx every single inch of the map. The outpost has been taken down, it's dope. Now we can capture this for ourselves, and then it's time, boys, for the Cold Heart. No Balrog. Who needs Balrog in 2022? Who needs catapults? I'm not a lemur, you know what I'm saying? Catapults is like for people who are lazy, you know, who are trying to find the laziest way of winning, but... I'm a fighter. I'm a warrior. I won't need catapults.
With us.
They're attacking over here.
Are you ready? Go to the tower.
All right. Okay, so it's time, boys. It's time, it's time. We're gonna bring the Witch King and Nazgul nearby to this Moomba Kills. And then we need to wait, you know, we need to wait until Darkness is back up. And then we know his rain is on cooldown because he used the rain after our Darkness. So basically we know, like, playing around cooldowns is very important. So we need to make stuff happen before his rain is back up. Okay, Cold Heart now. Okay, let's go, boys. The sound effect of Cold Heart is, by the way, immediate. I will make you listen. I will make you listen when I'm using it. Okay? Please listen carefully when I'm using the Cold Heart. It sounds so nice, dude. It sounds amazing.
We're finished digging the orc pit.
Okay. Alright, alright, dude. This army though, this is... Guys, please let me know in the comment section down below. Is this an army worthy of Mordor, or is this an army worthy of Mordor, okay? Three Nazgûls, Orcs, Mumakils, Trolls, Drama Trolls. Oh, look at them. Okay, guys, it's time. It's time. It's time. Watch this. Oh, yes, baby girl. Builds me an army worthy of Mordor. I mean, the amount of quality of life changes we have actually implemented, I'm very proud of them, you know what I'm saying? Like, not only the battling changes, but also quality of life changes. The graphics, the new textures, and also new sound effects. They are actually so cool. And they are not easy to be implemented, guys. So, just so you don't understand, I think we have invested so far over 300 hours. Like, me, 300 hours, and two other people, 300 hours. And Last Samurai is overwhelmed. GG well played, guys. I hope to see you next time. Until then, take care of yourselves. Keep hitting like a truck. And as always, stay beyond standards. Peace out.